Hey guys, this is Brent with Western Equipment, and in this video, I'm gonna be giving you 5 things to do before storing your mower for the winter. So if you'll stick with me here, we'll get started. Now, I know the general thought is that whenever I'm done with the mowing season, I've spent these last 3, 4, maybe even 5 months cutting this grass, that when I get done, I'm ready to put this bad boy in the shed or cover it, put it up, and I'm done with it for the winter. I'm done with the grass. I'm done with the mowing. I don't even want to think about it. But if you will take the time and do these 5 things before you put this mower up, then whenever it comes to springtime and you get ready to mow again, you have that many less things to do. And that way, if that grass sneaks up on you, it gets green and starts growing quick, you can just simply pull your mower out and go to cutting. So first thing is gonna be doing a full service on that mower before you put it up. Now, as I have right here, I've got my oil, my air filter, my filters, my spark plugs, and right here, that all would come in a home maintenance kit. So the simple thing to do, guys, is just to go out there, get that home maintenance kit, go ahead and perform that full service on this machine. And then that way you have that part done when you're going into the spring, where that engine is ready to go. You know, it's got fresh oil, it's got the fresh filter and spark plugs, and it's ready to start cutting. So first step, like I said, do that full service. If you're looking for one of these maintenance kits, maybe that's something that you're looking into that you need to get to go ahead and do this process. I'm gonna drop a link in the description below where you can go to buy one of those today. Step 2, guys, is gonna be one that we should be doing throughout the mowing season. It's a very important maintenance part to our machine. And that's gonna be going ahead and breaking out this grease gun and greasing all of those points on your mower that require that grease. Now, why we do this at the end of the season is this mower is gonna be sitting for months at a time here without being used. So we need to make sure that we're greasing those grease points, say they're on our front axle and also our spindles on our deck. And what this is gonna do is, since these parts are not moving, they're not being used, that grease isn't being moved around and lubricating those points. But what you are doing by pushing that grease into those greasable points is you're actually pushing it in there and filling the space where this grease is going and keeping moisture purged from those spots, which will eliminate the chance for damage from that moisture causing rust on those crucial points that are being greased. So step 2, make sure to break out that grease gun, grease all of those points on your mower. Now, we all know that over the winter, one of the main concerns, or anytime we have a piece of equipment sitting over a long period of time, is the battery. You know, is my battery staying up? Am I gonna have the chance of it being damaged due to the extreme cold? Is it going to discharge on me over the winter? So a good idea in step 3 is going to be go ahead and break out that trickle charger or that battery charger maintainer. Or if you don't have one, go out and purchase one. Make sure and get that put onto your machine. That way, over the winter, when that battery is sitting, you have that slow, steady charge on, which is going to help you eliminate a couple of different things. For one, by adding that slow, steady charge to that battery at all times, you will not give it the chance to discharge. Whenever discharge happens on a battery, we start to lose that charge. We can have damaging things happen, such as sulfation, which can be very, very damaging to the plates of your battery and ultimately cause that battery to not be able to work anymore for you. So to avoid that, and also to avoid those extreme colds of possibly freezing that battery and damaging it to where you don't, it's not able to be used. You may have a mess, it may crack or swell on the sides, but you can avoid that once again by going out, buying one of these trickle chargers, or if you have one, making sure and getting that put onto your machine at the end of the mowing season before you put it up for winter. So step 3, buy and install, or install if you have one, a trickle charger on that mower. So step 4 is gonna be one that can be one of the most frustrating things about putting your mower up for the winter, getting it back out, and it not being able to start. And a lot of that is caused by fuel issues and the fact that we've left fuel in the tank over that winter period. We didn't treat it, we put it up, we left some space in the tank to where there was able to be some condensation buildup. Then maybe we got a little bit of water in the fuel, or the old fuel may have gummed up our carburetor. Many, many different things can happen here. That's why step 4 is going to be taking care of our fuel system by adding a fuel stabilizer to that fuel. And we're also gonna fill that tank all the way up when we add that fuel stabilizer. Reason being here is the less space that we leave in this tank, the less room there is for condensation to happen on the walls of that tank, and the less chance we have of getting water in that fuel. Now, also by adding that fuel stabilizer, you're going to be able to keep that gas in its pure state that it needs to be in to be able to run whenever you're ready to go into the spring. Also by doing this, you're adding some cleaners and stabilizers that you're going to run through your fuel system. Once we add this, we're gonna go ahead and start the mower, let that get into our carburetor and into our fuel lines. That way we've made sure and stabilized every bit of fuel that's going to be in that system. Now, also a good tip is if you do have a fuel shutoff on your mower, once you've ran it for a little bit, we've gotten our tank full, we've gone ahead and ran that fuel with the stabilizer in it through the system, go ahead and turn that fuel shut off to the off position and let that mower run until it dies. That's just gonna make sure that we've got all the fuel out. You're not having any more fuel go to that carburetor and everything is burned out to where you should be able to, in the spring, go in, turn that fuel on, turn that mower on, let it run, and you've got that good stabilized fuel in the tank and you're already ready to go for spring. So, step four, we're gonna add that fuel stabilizer, run that system, make sure our fuel system's taken care of so we're ready for spring. So step five, again, is one that we've probably been taking care of throughout the year, but is a very good thing to check and make sure at the end of the year, once again, so we don't have to do it going into the spring. And that's going to be either changing and sharpening our blades and making sure to level that deck. Now, leveling the deck is very important. This is something that we're going to have done throughout the year, but we want to make sure and do this before we put it up, as the mower is going to be sitting, so you're not going to have that chance of the levelness of the deck changing, because what changes the levelness of the deck is the running through the grass, going over that rough terrain, having that deck bounce and move. So before we're going to put it up, we may as well go ahead and break out our leveling gauge, level that deck. That way, whenever it's sitting over the winter, we know that it's ready to pull out and it's level and ready to mow. Also, by changing our blades or going ahead and sharpening those, we know we can rest assured that when we pull that out, we are going to get that smooth cut. We're going to have either those fresh blades on or those sharp blades if we've sharpened them, and that way we know that we're ready to go whenever it comes to spring. So this can be a very tedious job. Sometimes it's kind of cumbersome since we have to get underneath the mower or pull the deck off. So we don't want to get caught in a situation where it's the start of spring and we really need to go mow, and this is something we need to do. So step five, go ahead and either change or sharpen those blades and level the deck. So a few other tips that I would throw out there, and these aren't things that are necessarily things that you have to do, but things that you should think about when you're putting up this mower is, for one, if we're going to leave our mower outside, one thing we should highly consider is to go ahead and cover the mower if we're gonna have it sit outside. Things like seats, the plastic on some of these mowers, the paint, all those things, if they're sitting for those months, do have that chance of either wearing or fading. So covering that mower if we have to keep it outside is something that I would highly encourage that you think about. Now, if you have a place to put your mower inside, whether it be a shop or a barn or maybe your garage, wherever that place may be, another thing you may think about is mice control. Now, I know this is something that nobody wants to think about, the fact that we have critters, little mice and things that are getting into our barns, but guys, it does happen. And one thing that can be very, very frustrating is you've gone through and you've done these five things, you've got this mower ready to go, it's put up, and then you come in and it still won't start. And the reason being is that we had a mouse get into our electrical system and chew a wire up. So there's nothing more frustrating than that. So we wanna think about how we're gonna control those mice if we have that issue. Now, one last thing, and this is something that kind of goes along with the other five things we've talked about. It's probably something that we've taken care of throughout the year, but one last thing you should consider is to go ahead and fix any of those pesky tires that you've got that go flat on you throughout the year. Now, as we go along, some of the things that we may do is we just air it up so we can get through and get done with mowing. But what you have to think about is when this mower is sitting for months on end over the winter, if that tire that you have that continuously goes flat on you stays flat for those months, what happens is that tire sits down onto the ground, and then we start having wear and cracking on the sidewalls of that tire, which can ultimately ruin that tire. So any of those pesky flats that you have that are troublesome throughout the year, before you go ahead and put this up for the winter, go ahead and take those off, either have them plugged or patched, you know, or fill them with a sealant and make sure that they're holding that air well before you put your mower up for the winter. All right, guys, so there you have it. There are the five things and a few extra tips of things you need to do before putting your mower up for winter. Now, I hope that after watching this video, I've given you some knowledge and some tips that you can use when you're going in to do this process. And also, guys, if I left anything out or you have any other comments or questions, make sure to leave those in the comments section below. It's that way I can get back to you. Also, guys, if you like this video and if it helped you out, I would just ask that you would please hit that like button and give us a subscribe, as that helps us out as well. And also, guys, keep in mind that if you need any of the things that we talked about in this video today, whether it be that home maintenance kit, those blades, the leveling gauge, the fuel protect, or the trickle charger, or the grease and grease gun, any of those things, guys, I'm going to leave a link in the description below where you can get those. And if you have any other parts needs for that John Deere equipment, whether it be tractors, lawnmowers, gators, whatever those things may be, make sure to go check us out at west-equip.com/parts. And as always, guys, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Hey guys, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and go buy your parts at west-equip.com/parts.